Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show on Legends 100.3, the place to fine-tune your swing, dress for the course, club, or cruise, and get tips on the best places to play and stay at the right price. Vacation or staycation, host Dan Shube, along with his expert guests, will tell you where to go to play golf and vacation, that is. Now, here's Dan.
Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show. I'm your host, Dan Shube. And this morning, we're going to talk some golf. We're going to talk some travel. Actually, I'll be talking a little bit about my own travel as I'm currently in Budapest, Hungary. And of course, joining me from the Legends Radio Studio is Mike McGann. How are you doing today, Mike?
I'm just one of the last things you expect on a golf and travel show here in South Florida is for Dan to be in Budapest. It's a kind of that's some travel, my friend.
It is. Actually, I came here via Istanbul as well. I didn't have the time to get out of the airport because my flight was delayed a little bit. But these are some interesting places that not everybody is in all the time. But it's been really cool so far. And I think what we'll do is we'll fill everybody in a little bit in the next segment because this is the Golf and Travel Show. The Masters was last week, so I don't think we can possibly avoid talking about that. So I think what we'll do is I got some deals on travel later in the show. We'll see if we got time for that too. But my trip is only half complete. So next week we're going to hear the rest of the trip. But it's been pretty cool. So why don't we catch up a little bit about the golf world, and then I'll talk a little bit about Istanbul and Budapest as well, okay, which has just been amazing. So last week, of course, was the Masters, and congratulations to Jon Rahm. He pulled away from the field on Sunday. It was a pretty tough battle with Brooks Koepka, who seemed to have tired out. Maybe it's because he's used to only playing three rounds, not four, on a regular basis. I don't know. But Mr. Rahm, I mean, no surprise. He's been in the top three in the rankings for quite some time now. He's got plenty of games. So it was cool. And he was a little bit choked up at the end. He gave kudos to his idol and inspiration for playing, Seve Ballesteros. And he was just very emotional, and it was nice to watch. He's a good guy. He deserved to win. So I enjoyed it immensely. And, of course, the golf course is always, the winner. I mean, Augusta National, just beautiful. So I enjoyed watching it. There were a lot of other stories, though, as well. Phil Mickelson, for one, he's a guy that we never expected to be anywhere. He's the past year or two, he can't win a thing. He's been finishing last.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, he shoots the best rounds he's ever shot in a Masters, a 65 on the final round, 7 under, and was competing to win the damn thing. It was remarkable. So not my favorite player or person, but you got to give him kudos. It was a great performance. So that was kind of interesting to see, if nothing else. Also, amateur Sam Bennett was in like second or third place for a while. The highest finishing amateur in like decades.
Wow.
This guy, I mean, he was just tearing it up out there. Cool as can be. He's he's 21 years old, and he's been talking about going back to Texas A&M for a fifth year. But if I was him, I might want to think about turning pro.
I would definitely consider that with that kind of stat.
He doesn't even need to finish college. I mean, everyone says they want to, and I understand that. But with the kind of money he can make with that golf game, he can't make more money doing anything else.
No, it's like the LeBron James of golf. Take the deal.
Yes, exactly. And you could always, in your spare time, online, or you could go back to school one day. It's not an emergency right now. Go play golf.
Strike while the 9-iron is hot.
Exactly. Some bad news for Will Zalatoris. He had to back out of the Masters due to bad back and had to get surgery. So he's out for the rest of the year. Hopefully he will heal quickly and get back. He's a nice guy. Tiger Woods had to withdraw as well. His foot issues came back again. Right from the first round, you could see he was hobbled.
Yes.
He did not look good at all. Barely made the cut, which was a victory for him because it was the 23rd consecutive cut that he made there. So he wanted to do that, but then I think he regretted it because then he had to keep playing.
Ugh.
And he's in bad shape. You know, he had said that this could be his last Masters. It's a possibility. He also said, you know, I mean, all of the majors is really all he's focused on, but he may at some point have to make an announcement that he's doing his farewell tour for the majors and for the PGA Tour. But he did confirm that news that we recently heard from Jack Nicklaus, that he's actually looking forward to, you know, playing some events, at least on the Champions Tour, where he's okay using a cart. So
right.
We'll see. We'll see. You know, it's not the last we're going to see of Tiger, it looks like, one way or another. And that's cool because, you know, he's just he is golf. Rory McIlroy, he played in the Masters but missed the cut. And I don't know if he's not feeling well, if he needs a rest, if he needs to work on his game. But he signed up to play in this week's RBC Heritage event, which is one of those elevated events where the purse is really big. And he was instrumental in making some of the decisions and the rules for these elevated events. And as it turns out, there's a clause in this, the rules, that once you sign up for the event, if you then withdraw, you get fined.
Oh, Lord.
So well. Mr. McIlroy, he took a week off at a cost of $3 million. But he made the rule.
Well, decisions, I guess, right?
Crazy, right? So yes, they'll be finishing up a little bit later today at the RBC Heritage at Harbortown Golf Links in Hilton Head Island. Because it's an elevated event, it's a very, very strong field. So you could tune into that a little bit later today. The women will also be finishing up much later today. No, actually, they finished up, I guess, last night. Remember, I'm 6 hours ahead. So, but they were playing in Hawaii.
It's time travel, Dan. That's what we're doing here.
Oh, they do not have the Golf Channel on in Hungary. just say. Also finishing up later this afternoon is the World Long Drive Championship for the long drivers in Hope Sound. So I'm not sure what the ticket situation is, but you might still have time to drive up to Hope Sound to check it out. So
get there faster than they get to Budapest.
Probably so. So Google it. World Long Drive is the group that's putting it on. And if you've never seen the long drive guys hit the ball 400-plus yards, it's something to see. I've seen some of them in action. So very, very cool. All right. What we're going to do is we're going to take a very, very quick break. And then I'm going to tell everybody about my travels through Istanbul to Budapest. You don't want to miss it, so stay tuned. We'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show.
My sand iron away, my best ring thought of the day is to use the Texas wedge. When you put one in the hole.
Hi, Golf and Travel listeners. It's Dan Shube here with a message for your retirement. Golf and retirement go hand in hand, and when looking for a retirement advisor, trust and experience are two qualities to look for, and my friend Jupiter Joe Thomas possesses both of these. Whether you're in retirement or looking to retire, give local expert Joe Thomas a call at 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999, or go to jupiterjoe.com. That's jupiterjoe.com. Mention my name, Dan Shube, and receive a free copy of Joe's book, Retirement Know-It-All. After I read his book, I became a client. His advice has allowed me to sleep easy and not worry about retirement. Phone again is 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or just go to jupiterjoe.com. That's jupiterjoe.com. Easy, right?
It went straight down the middle. Then it started to hook just a wee, wee bit. And that's when my caddy lost sight of it. That little white pellet has never been found to this day. But it went straight down the middle, like they say. Whack down the fairway.
And we are back, and as promised, I'm going to fill everybody in on what I've been up to the past few days. And I like to review everything for everyone's benefit. So
I'm excited for this. Like, this is so cool.
So first of all, I booked my flight here on Turkish Air, and a lot of people said to me, Turkish Air?
Turkish Air?
You know, where did you come up with that?
Is that even a real thing?
But Yeah, but they're rated as a 5-star airline. And I have to say that the plane was excellent and the service was excellent as well. The people are as friendly as can be. The exact opposite of, you know, some of these discount economy airlines, you know, like Spirit, where they treat you like an animal. They treated us so well. And we were in economy class. I think I had mentioned to you previously that I had spent about $700 round trip on this. I had to pay a little extra to get my seat, you know, and stuff like that, like all airlines are these days if you're buying an economy ticket typically. But I was able to bring a carry-on in that cost. I was able to check a suitcase as well at no extra cost. You know, they gave us meals and drinks, and I mean, it was just lovely.
That's great.
And on top of that, you know, we went through Istanbul Airport, and it's only about 4 years old, this airport, and it is magnificent. Absolutely beautiful, spotless. The shops and the restaurants are incredible. I mean, it literally makes Fort Lauderdale Airport look like a third world country. Okay, so just to, you know, the basic comparison. So unfortunately, we were a little bit late in getting there. And, you know, they also have this program where if you have a long layover, depending on how long, if it's overnight, they'll put you up in a 4-star hotel if you fly economy, or if you're business class, a 5-star hotel on them. Or you, if you have like a 5 or 6 hour layover and it's not overnight, they'll put you on a tour of some sorts of the city and buy you a meal, all on them. Just, you know, they're trying to get people to check out Istanbul in Turkey. And I took the bait, and I wish I would have had some time to actually see the city, but it just didn't work out, unfortunately. So I have no problem flying Turkish Air again. And one day I hope to get back to Istanbul and actually see the city.
That sounds so cool.
But then it's very, very cool. And so from there, we flew on to Budapest. And staying at the Hilton Garden Inn in Pest, which, of course, Budapest is the tale of two cities, basically. On one side of the Danube is Pest. On the other side is Buda. And they combine the two to make Budapest. But so we're here at the Hilton Garden Inn. It is centrally located where, if it wasn't for the rain that we're getting a little bit of, it's easy to walk from here to almost everything. Again, modern, clean. The people are friendly. The breakfast, like a full buffet breakfast they have here, almost as if it was like a full-fledged Hilton, not a Garden Inn like, you know, typically in the States. Just wonderful. And it costs about $150 a night.
It for that?
it's less than you'd pay like in Miami or Fort Lauderdale. And this is Europe. I mean, the dollar is strong against the currencies here. And it goes a long way, especially in Budapest. It's just a place for, you know, pretty good deals. So from here, I've been adventuring and checking out whatever I can through the rain and stuff, and I'm not quite done yet, but some of the things that I've seen so far, I'll fill everybody in on. For instance, just up the block from where I'm sitting is St. Stephen's Cathedral. It's on a level with the Sistine Chapel. Okay. Mm. So this is just a grand, grand cathedral. It took like 54 years for them to build it. It's massive. It's gorgeous. You know, I can't recommend it highly enough. And like I say, just literally a couple of blocks away from here. In the other direction, I haven't gotten a chance to go in yet, but a couple of blocks the other way is their famous opera house, which I've seen pictures of. I couldn't get a ticket to the opera. And I haven't had a chance to get a tour yet, but from the outside, it looks incredible. And I've seen the pictures. Think of like 5 levels of balconies with ornate decorations. And I mean, just crazy, crazy stuff in this city. We also visited Hero Square, which, you know, in Europe, they got all these gigantic squares and this gigantic monument to the, you know, military defenders of Budapest and all of their heroes and stuff. And it's right in what's called City Park, which is an absolutely beautiful park. One thing that I noticed that was really cool, they have this gigantic ice skating rink. Of course, it's not cold enough for it to be open. It's not refrigerated. And I can only imagine in the winter how cool it is, but literally how cool it is. That's why I won't be here in the winter. But they're very, very beautiful. Also, it's a foodie town, Budapest. There are incredible restaurants everywhere. You need to be a little adventurous, though, because there is not a part of an animal that they will not serve.
Okay. Wow.
Yeah, it's like if you like Eye of Newt, you know, that's what you could probably order, you know. So, but there's something for everybody, so you don't have to do that. Also, incredible desserts and pastries and gelatos and I mean, you could really eat your way through the city. It's wonderful. Another place that there's tons of museums, but I'm not really big on all of the museums. And you know, if you've gone to one, you've kind of gone to them all. But there was one museum that caught my eye, also a relatively short walk from my hotel here. It's called the Museum of Illusions. And if you get a chance, go to the Facebook page. Did you take a look at the pictures I posted by?
I did, and that is so up my alley. I love that whole thing.
It was so cool. It's not big. You know, it takes maybe an hour or so to go through. But they have all these incredible illusions and stuff that you literally cannot believe your eyes, the things that you're seeing. This town actually is the birthplace of Houdini.
Oh, that makes sense then.
Yeah, that's over on the Buddha side where I'm probably going to go tomorrow. I'm going to be checking out the Buddha castle over there and, a couple other things in that area. I don't know if I'll get a chance to check out his home or his museum, but they're very proud of the fact that he came from here. So, the city is just incredible. And you know, with the post that of course, go to facebook.com/thegolfandtravelshow. I'm going to post some more pictures in the next day or two as I take them so you could, keep up to date with all the things that are going on here. But I can't tell you how many people have commented to me about Budapest that have been here and how beautiful it is and how much they loved it. Well, you know what else they're really big on here is coffee.
So
if you're into gourmet coffee.
You know I am.
Right? Well, there are so many coffee houses that are so cool, and if you like, to drink a little bit, they've got these bars here that are built like in the old part of town. They look like caves and things. And how about a funny story? So we walk into the hotel a little while ago and stumbled upon like six or seven guys hanging out by the elevator. And one of them is wearing a skirt. And it's like, okay. And then I look up and he's got a dolphin shirt on. And we asked one of the other guys what was going on, and I kind of figured it out before he answered, but it was a bachelor party, and the guy likes the dolphins, so they made him dress like that for the bachelor party.
That's hysterical.
That is hysterical. I mean, of all teams, it's the Dolphins, right, here in Budapest. And I did read that they have a lot of bachelor and bachelorette parties because at night, not that I'm into partying like that these days, but it's a party town, and the place goes crazy at night with the bars and the clubs and the discos, and it's a party town. So a lot of people come here for their parties. So, like I say, I've only seen some of the city so far, and it's incredible. So all I could do is encourage everybody, if you get a chance, go to Budapest. You won't regret it.
And, that sounds awesome.
It's really not that expensive. Even with the airfare and stuff, it's probably the same price as a vacation in Los Angeles or something, So give it some thought, and I recommend it. And, of course, if you go to facebook.com/thegolfandtravelshow, you can always message me, and I have no problem sharing more information or answering questions to anybody who would like to take advantage of what I'm taking advantage of because it's just wonderful. So, and next week I will be reporting on the rest of my trip. I'll be back in the studio by then. But from here, I'm on my way to Bratislava for just a day and then Vienna for a couple of days. So it should be equally cool. I'm looking forward to it. And, of course, I'll be sharing it with everybody. So, but I do have some deals to travel elsewhere.
Okay.
So after the break, we're going to take a very quick break, and then I'll fill everybody in on some really, really good deals. Mostly, I think they're all airfare deals. So that's usually the biggest expense is getting there. So if we could get you there cheap, that's a good start.
Exactly.
So, you don't want to miss it. Stay tuned. We'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show.
I'll be looking for my ball until the dark of the night. You play 18 holes.
Hi, Golf and Travel listeners. It's Dan Shube here with a message for your retirement. Golf and retirement go hand in hand. And when looking for a retirement advisor, trust and experience are two qualities to look for. And my friend, Jupiter Joe Thomas, possesses both of these. Whether you're in retirement or looking to retire, give local expert Joe Thomas a call at 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Mention my name, Dan Shube, and receive a free copy of Joe's book, Retirement Know-It-All. After I read his book, I became a client. His advice has allowed me to sleep easy and not worry about retirement. Phone again is 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or just go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Easy, right?
And we are back. And one or two other quick things about my evening plans tonight here in Budapest. I'm going to try and go into the Jewish Quarter to a restaurant that has klezmer music. So for anybody that's into klezmer music, they have that here.
Love klezmer music. I think there's nothing quite like it. I'm a big fan. So that's so cool that that's there.
And I also, I forgot to mention today, I went to the synagogue here, which is the second largest one in the world, second to New York. And, I mean, built like, you know, a cathedral as well. Just very, very impressive. But to be even funnier, so after the klezmer music, if I get there, there is a comedy show at a club. And the performer is from Los Angeles.
Okay.
It's in English.
All right.
And it seems that in the Euro, European countries here, that there's a circuit of English-speaking comedians that are very popular.
Wow. Okay, I did not see that coming.
Me neither. I do the research and I see these things, and it's like, okay, if I can get there, I will. So it's very possible that tonight I will go from klezmer music to comedy here in Budapest.
I love that. Wow, that's so cool, though. I love, there's so much variety. I just had no idea.
Again, me either, until I started doing all the research. So it's just, again, you don't have regrets and go back home and find out you missed something that you could have done. So that's my policy. So anyway, now, if you can't make it to Budapest, you might want to make it to Nashville, Tennessee, because right now, from Fort Lauderdale, you can fly nonstop to Nashville for $98.
Okay.
Round trip.
I'm sorry. Did you say $98?
I did. And it's on one of the major carriers. It's not like on Breeze or Spirit or anything like that. So, I mean, again, you may have to pay extra to get a seat or check a bag or whatever. But go for 2-3 days and just, you know, take a carry-on or something you can shove under the seat, a backpack, and have fun in Nashville. You know, I mean, how cool is that? How about Montego Bay in Jamaica?
All right.
Right now, nonstop round trip from Fort Lauderdale, $260. Not bad.
Not
usually
bad at all.
Usually pretty expensive. Or if you prefer a different island, how about to Punta Cana from Fort Lauderdale, $265 on JetBlue. Good airline, one of my favorites.
And a great
pretty
spot.
Good price as well. It is, and I love Punta Cana, not just, you know, for the beaches and the hotels, the casinos, but the golf is incredible in Punta Cana, my favorite golf course. Punta Espada is there. I mean, it is my favorite golf course I've ever played, and obviously I've played a lot of golf around the world. So, again, write to me, and I'll help you out. I'll tell you where to go. How about Lima, Peru? There's a place that you've been wanting to go to.
Oh, yeah, that keeps coming back. The universe is trying to tell me something, Dan.
But you know, sometimes we find a really good, you know, package, but not necessarily airfare. Right now, they have airfare from Fort Lauderdale nonstop to Lima, $307 round trip.
300 to Peru, 307?
Yes. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Crazy, right?
Unreal.
All right, and Europe is on sale right now, too. So if you, too, would like to go check out Europe, almost all of Europe is on sale at crazy prices right now. I'll give you, for instance, and all of these are from Miami because, you know, to get overseas without too many connections, you typically need to go out of Miami. I did to get here. But right now, you can go round trip from Miami to Rome, $492.
You know, I keep on, I'm so used to these being 1,000 and up. That it's still mind-blowing whenever it doesn't hit four figures.
Well, I think that the normal price, according to what I have here, is about $850.
Yeah.
So it's a little more than half price. But if you want to go to Prague, which is probably 100 or 200 miles from where I'm sitting right now, $474 round trip. Porto in Portugal, $496. Or Barcelona, $498 right now. So pretty much all of Europe is on sale for under $500, which, I mean, again, you could pay a lot more than that to fly in the U.S.
Yeah. You know?
So, I mean, it's pretty incredible. Oh, Milan is on sale too, $503, so it's a tiny bit more. And if you'd rather go out of West Palm, you could get to Milan for $597, which is pretty cool as well. So, yeah, the world is your oyster. Go check it out.
It really is.
Stay home. You know, it's just waiting for you, and don't let it pass you by.
Well, you're certainly not. I mean, you're out there doing it, my friend.
Yeah, I've been trying to make this particular trip for a couple of years, and of course, the pandemic kind of, you know, put it on ice for a little bit, but I never forgot about it, and as soon as I got a chance, I jumped on it, and I recommend it everybody. When you get a chance, jump on it, you know? All right, so I want to thank our sponsor, of course, Retirement Network Advisors, Jupiter Joe Thomas, not just a friend. He advises me, and thanks to him, I'm here. So
nice.
You can reach him at jupiterjoe.com, ask for his free book, tell him I sent you, and he'll give it to you. And I highly recommend him. And, of course, you can also listen to his show, the Jupiter Joe Money Show, right here on Legends Radio at 9:30. And, of course, you can always go to facebook.com/The Golf and Travel Show, like the page, and you'll know what I'm up to. And from there, you can always send me a message. I'm happy to help any of our listeners with their travel plans so that you, too, can see the world, not break the bank, and enjoy your life. Why not, right? You only got one life to live. You may as well enjoy it, right?
True story.
All right, so next week I will be back in the studio with you, Mike. Looking forward to sharing the rest of my travels with everybody, and hopefully you'll tune in. And in the meantime, just make sure that you hit them straight.
The movies and the factories and every stranger's face I see reminds me that I long to be.
Thanks for listening to the Golf and Travel Show hosted by Dan Shube. Dan's here every Sunday at 7 a.m. to help you hit them straight, whether you're in Palm Beach County or traveling around the world. We'll see you next Sunday morning for more of the Golf and Travel Show right here on Legends 100.3.